Good evening, Colonial parents, family, and friends, and welcome to our Colonial COVID-compliant modified spring concert. We are super proud of the folks that you see here in front of you this evening in our music department. Again, as building principal, and my name is Matt Muller. I know a lot of you have seen you in the past and the different events and types of things of that nature. We're very fortunate. A lot of schools, you know, basically put music and different things like that on the shelf for this school year. We fought a little bit about that. We had the support of our school board, our district administration, and we tried anything we could do to keep the fire going and keep the passion alive. And this is the fruits of the labor. It wasn't easy by any stretch of the imagination. Our folks had to get extremely creative with how they did things. We're here tonight. I know a lot of you, you're doing the right thing. We have signs back there, two seats between you, every other row. We have the mask while we're in the building. No one likes that. We're all doing that. But again, it's what we have to do to do what we're doing here tonight. So again, I can't be more proud of the kids behind me and the department that we have here in the music area. So without any further ado, I'd ask you just to kill your cell phones a little bit there for the volume. Make sure the noise is off. That's always a key thing here. But again, it's modified, it's abbreviated, but it's going to be good. We're excited to keep music live here in New Washington. Enjoy the show.
good evening and welcome again to the orchestra portion of tonight's concert. We are just so fortunate to be here tonight and playing for a live audience. My name is Mrs. McDaniel. I know that there's several of you I haven't even gotten to meet yet due to being remote a lot and hybrid, so nice to meet you. This is our first time playing together for an audience this year, and it's just so great to be here. The piece that they just played is Wood Splitter Fanfare. That was actually a favorite that we had scheduled to play at last year's spring concert. So the eighth graders had just started learning this and were really excited to play it, and then we got shut down and never got to play it. So I decided when we found out we were going to have a concert and be all together again, I said we've got to do Wood Splitter Fanfare for these eighth graders who worked so hard in seventh grade and never got to perform it. And the seventh graders just pulled their own weight. They came right up alongside them and learned it. And didn't they do an awesome job? The next piece that we're going to play for you, you may recognize, is Don't Stop Believin'. Was a lot of fun to play, but it was a lot of work. Even in a normal year when I would see these students more often, that would have been hard to put together, so I'm very proud of them for doing that one as well. It was just a lot of fun to play, and I'm glad they got to perform it for you today. Our final piece is Mozart Symphony No. 15 in G major. It's a lovely little string arrangement that had our violins going up in the third position and our different instruments doing lots of different new things that I was really excited to do with them. So enjoy our final piece.
outstanding performance. Let's hear it again for our orchestra. Those of you who know me know I'm a bit of a storyteller too. I guess that's the old coach coming out of me, but I got a story about our orchestra. A few months ago, my secretary radioed me on the walkie-talkie, said, "You gotta get down to the orchestra room before you end the wits. You know, you gotta get down there." I'm thinking, what could be wrong in the orchestra room? There's nothing ever wrong in the orchestra room. So I'm hurrying up to get down in there, and I just hit a milestone. I turned 50 a few months ago. And I walk in, I come flying in the door, and there they are, and they're serenading me to happy birthday that they just learned in a few minutes before. So you talk about adaptable and talented. I'm not sure how long it took you to do that, but that was pretty amazing. So what a great group. Thank you all.
And I just want to say one more thank you to Mr. Mueller and the rest of the administration, to our tech crew, to the custodians and the wonderful music staff that I work with, everybody that went into this concert. And thank you all for coming and for supporting your children, and have a wonderful evening.
Mr. Warner, there you go. Folks, be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We put these pictures out there too, so they're not always the best, but we put them out as much as we can. We try and tell our story. So at this point, everyone, we do need to have exit. We have to re-ticket for the choir portion. So everyone has to exit.
Thank you. police force.
Good evening, Colonial parents, family, and friends, and welcome. Some of you were here for the orchestra, welcome back, and if you weren't, welcome anyway. I'm Matt Muller, building principal here at New Oxford Middle School. We're extremely proud to be able to pull off our COVID-compliant, modified spring concert here. Again, I see you guys are following the protocol there, helping us out with that, and again, it's not easy. The whole thing hasn't been easy all year long, but I'll tell you, we couldn't be prouder of the group that we have behind us and the one we just saw, and of course the band coming up next. Again, a lot of schools put the clamps on music and those types of things this year, but our board, our administration down in the central office, and the folks here behind me were really adamant about trying this and pulling it off, and it wasn't easy the entire time, but they made it work and they made it happen, and I think you're gonna enjoy what you're about ready to see here tonight. So again, Ms. Watson-Martin and your gang, take it away. Thank you, folks.
Thank you.
You can see it's a little bit of chaos tonight. The theme is just make sure you are in the right section. That's the theme for tonight. That first piece that we just sang, that is the Liberian folk song called Banya. It's a favorite here at New Oxford Middle School. We learn it in seventh grade music class, and it's just a really fun round, lots of fun drums. And as you all saw, we had a mass amount of drum players, and Addison Green was our awesome cowbell player. Literally would not have been possible without Addison. So would you mind giving our percussionist another round of applause? So the next couple of songs we're going to do, the next song we're going to perform, it's called Howdy Dow Diddle on Day. You all might know this song better as The Leatherwing Bat. If we have any Peter, Paul, Mary fans out there, this is one of their great hits. It's a great rendition of it. So when we were talking about the song, it was all fun and games talking about the Leatherwing Bat. But a few weeks ago, Mr. Borba had an actual bat appear in his classroom. So I told Mr. Borba, from now on, we will not be singing songs about wild animals because there seems to be a curse in this building that they will appear when we sing about them. After we sing Howdy Dow Diddle Em Day, we will be doing a gospel song called Ticket to the Kingdom. This is a gospel song written by Donald Moore. We've been exploring minor keys, which is really fun about this song, and also really fast text. You'll notice both Howdy Dow and Ticket to the Kingdom are on the faster side, and we've been working on clear dictation, even with our masks on. So we hope you enjoy this performance, and this is Howdy Dow Diddle Em Day.
Thank you. song of the night will be Corner of the Sky. This is a song from the musical Pippin. This is kind of like his self-discovery song in the musical. He is the son of Charlemagne, and he's trying to figure out how is he going to own up to be like the great ruler that his father is. Before we perform our final song, I'd just like to take a minute to thank all of these wonderful students and their parents. This year was quite the journey, not only because we were in the middle of a pandemic, but also I was on a maternity leave for half the year, so this is quite a crazy year. I couldn't be prouder of the work and the dedication that these students have put towards this concert, and I'm just so thankful that we are here. I'd like to extend a huge thank you to all of you parents, friends, family out here that have supported us this year. This would not be possible without you. So students, can you please applaud your parents? I would also like to thank our accompanist, Alex. So Alex, if you could stand, please. And thank you for the CVSD tech crew who helped us live stream this and make all of our tech needs possible. We need to switch, so can we have 7th graders and 8th graders switch? So usually during the spring concert, I choose a song that features our 8th graders, so you will notice one of the verses is just going to be our 8th graders. Our 7th graders have worked really hard on just standing there and smiling for this song. So you'll see their lovely smiles during one of the verses. 8th graders, I'm going to miss you. It was a crazy 2 years. You guys are awesome. Please come back and visit me, okay? 7th graders. You all are crazy in the best way possible, and I am so excited for next year. I'm so excited to see what next year is going to look like, hopefully in a more normal setting. So you guys are great, too. I like the 8th graders, but you guys are pretty awesome, too. Just saying. This last song is going to feature 4 soloists. They're going to come up front. This features Adi Dussault, Zach Johnson, Maddie Knoll, and Celicia Salazar. So I hope you enjoy our final performance.
Thank you.
One more hand for our amazing choir. Very nice job, everyone. And parents, family, and friends, we appreciate you coming. Again, at this point, as is customary with these modified concerts, we're going to ask everyone to step out, to leave the auditorium. If you're here for band, you'll have another colored ticket. That's just protocol and procedure. So we'll do that. We'll open this back up here in a few minutes for the band to come back in. Thanks again for coming, folks. Good evening, parents, family, and friends, and welcome to our third and final edition of our COVID-compliant modified spring concert. And again, I'm Matt Miller, building principal here at New Oxford Middle School. We welcome you all to our show. We couldn't be more proud of the group we have behind us here, and Mr. Warball and the music department, for what they've been able to pull off. I mean, it's not been easy. Some of you were here last session here and heard me say the same thing. A lot of schools are putting the programs like this on the shelf, not doing that. Our school board, our central administration, these folks, myself, Mr. Beeman, we thought it was essential that we try to keep this fire lit, you know, in music and how important that is. And again, I think what you're gonna find, it's not been easy, but they have found a way, and if there wasn't a way, they made a way, you know, to make this happen. And I couldn't be more proud, and I think you're gonna be real excited about what you're gonna hear for the next 15 minutes. So take it away, Mr. R.
Thank you, Mr. Miller. Just a little explanation about our first piece tonight. Good evening, everyone. Dark matter, it's a science term that they use to try and explain gravitational pull between the planets. They don't really know if it actually exists. So this is kind of one of those more kind of deep songs, I guess you'd say. But if you're curious, like, I think I've heard that term before. If you watch The Big Bang Theory, Sheldon talks about it all the time. This is dark matter. Before we play our next song, there's actually two students on the stage I'd like to recognize tonight for accomplishments. They went above and beyond this year with all the craziness and everything else. There's two individuals I'd like to recognize. First one is Craig Savage. Stand up, Craig. Okay, Craig. Yeah. So, Mr. Compapiano, our high school band director, was looking for help with his jazz band and said something to me kind of on the side. He's like, hey, I need a couple of kids. I said, well, I got a really good sax player. He's like, I'll take him. And Craig filled in on Barry sax, right, Craig? Yeah, baritone sax for the high school jazz band this year. So I think that's outstanding. Congratulations, Craig. And happens to be sitting right beside him, Katie Trewinski. Please stand up, Katie. Each year, the Pennsylvania Music Educators Association holds festivals, and even during the pandemic, they found a way to do this virtually. There was an audition process back in December. Katie submitted videos of herself playing two different excerpts from a very hard piece of music, and she qualified for the District Band Festival again this year. This is the second year in a row she's done that, so great job, Katie. Congratulations again. Just to be clear, that ensemble is made up of students in grades 7 through 12 in York, Adam, and Lancaster County. So it's not like it's a small deal. This is a huge deal that she's done that 2 years in a row. So great job, Katie. Our next piece, Hidden Wonders. The title comes from the composer's sense of the band that it was written for. There's a small program in the state of New York, a middle school band. The students did artwork and little musicals, little songs and things, and he used all these ideas. And he called it Hidden Wonder because he believes that they're a little hidden gem in the state of New York as a band program. This is Hidden Wonders.
Thank you.
good then.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're doing great. Before we play our final selection this evening, I also would like to add my thanks, my many list of thanks. I got to start at the top, Dr. Rudesill, Mr. Muller, Mr. Beeman. The administration has been absolutely spectacular through this process, supporting what we're trying to do and making it all happen. So thank you all very much. To you all sitting out here this evening, thank you so much. I'm sure the conversation happened in just about every home of, well, do I even want to do band this year? So thank you for helping, encouraging them to stick it out, okay? And that's what I'm gonna say. Please continue to encourage them to stick it out. Look, this has been so weird for all of us. I guarantee you the benefits of staying in will pay off in the long run, okay? So please encourage them to do that. And finally, my biggest thank you, you guys. You have been absolutely amazing this year, really. I can't thank you enough. Eighth graders, please, just keep going. That trip up the ramp isn't as big a deal as you think. You will have a blast in the high school band if you just go with it. Just dive in and go. And seventh graders, get ready. You're my leaders next year, okay? I need you to step up, okay? So that day's coming real, real, real soon. Don't blink, and we'll be back here in August. Okay, so enough of that. Our final tune, easily the most challenging thing we're doing this evening. Each song we've done has progressively gotten a little more difficult. This medley from The Lion King has been a challenge for us to put together. They worked really hard at it, and we hope you enjoy The Lion King.
Thank you.
Colonial Parents. Isn't live music great? I told you we'd be impressed. Big round of applause for our band and Mr. Robo as they close out our modified spring concert. God love them. Folks, thanks for coming again. A few more days left in our school year. We'll get through this and we'll be better and stronger and better forward for next year. So thanks again for coming, and that concludes our concert. Appreciate it. One thing I would add, folks, is follow us on Facebook and Twitter. We tell our story here at New Oxford Middle School. We push out pictures and stuff all the time, so that includes tonight.
If there, if three of them are here, then they can't be holding up.